pendulum is set up as a mass on a cable. As the pendulum swings from the highest point to the lowest point, the energy transitions from gravitational potential energy, the blue curve, to kinetic energy, the pink curve. At the top of the swing, the energy is all gravitational potential energy, while at the bottom of the swing, the energy is in the form of kinetic energy. The total energy is always constant, shown by the yellow line. This, of course, depends on several assumptions, namely that there is no energy lost by the pendulum during the pendulum's motion. We assume there is a frictionless pivot and no air resistance. In order for the mathematics of this to work out neatly, we also assume a massless rigid cable and a small angle of swing. From a force balance in radial coordinates, we find a differential equation for the angular acceleration of the pendulum. The solution is in the form of a sinusoid and can be simplified by invoking the small angle approximation and dropping the constant terms. The derivative of the solution gives the angular velocity, which can then be used to compute the kinetic energy of the pendulum. The gravitational potential energy is determined by the height above the zero potential point, which we will define to be the bottom of the pendulum's swing. This can be calculated based on the trigonometric relationships. Again, with the small angle approximation, the cosine can be rewritten. From the solution of the angular acceleration differential equation, the angle is given as a function of a cosine. The gravitational potential energy is therefore a function of the square of the cosine term. The phases of the pendulum swing are illustrated here. At the bottom of the swing, the pendulum is swinging at its highest velocity and at its zero potential point. Therefore, as shown in the graph, the pendulum has all kinetic energy and zero gravitational potential energy. As the pendulum swings up, it slows down and its kinetic energy is transformed to gravitational potential energy. The animation shows pendulum transform energy between kinetic energy and gravitational potential energy, while always maintaining total mechanical energy. While the energy can change form, it cannot be destroyed or created. The total energy must remain constant. This concept is known as the first law of thermodynamics. If we assume that the pendulum is an adiabatic system, energy does not flow into or out of the system, then we can safely say that when I allow this bowling ball to drop from right in front of my face, when the pendulum returns, it will not go past the point from which I dropped it. It starts at this level, where it has its maximum gravitational potential energy, and travels to this level, the zero potential level, where it has no gravitational potential energy, but the same amount in kinetic energy. When it travels back to the same height that it was released from, it will have the same amount of energy, but it will once again be in the form of gravitational potential energy. Let's take a look at the whole demonstration. When the pendulum returns, will it hit me in the face? No, I am safe because of the first law of thermodynamics. Remember, the energy in the pendulum system can change between kinetic and gravitational potential energy, but the total energy will remain the same. There are some safety considerations in performing such a demonstration. Only release the bowling ball, never push it or toss it. Make sure the cable is straight. A small angle helps with this. Never move your head toward the pendulum, and make sure the pivot cannot move. Here we see the pendulum once again swinging back and forth. In reality, our system is losing energy in the form of friction at the pivot, and a very small amount to air resistance. Nevertheless, the pendulum will never swing past the height from which it was released. The energy lost from the system is not destroyed, but rather it too has transformed to another type of energy. As with most frictional losses, some of that energy is now thermal energy at the pivot point. We have learned that energy cannot be created or destroyed. However, energy can be transformed from one type to another.